So as you can see, I'm in storage here right now, and pretty much what I got here is just the stuff that I've been getting together for the opening of the new store. Just a bunch of sneakers. I think I probably have about 100 pairs or so that haven't been put out for sale yet at my other location that I'm saving for the grand opening of the next store. We got a stack of Supreme tees right there. These boxes are all filled with Dunks. And then there's also boxes full of Essentials clothing down there. Some more Supreme clothing and a little bit of Bape and Kiss as well. And then we just got more shoes back there. So, yes, sir. Again, stuff ready. I'm going to do a good amount of buying over the course of the next 2 weeks to get, you know, the biggest amount of quantity I can for the grand opening. And then we plan to do it on June 3rd and 4th. It's a Saturday and a Sunday. It'll be a two-day event. So coming up on it pretty quick, so I don't got that much time, but I'll get it done, guys, like I always do. All right, guys, thanks for following up and enjoy the video. All right, guys, we are inside 508 Streetwear today. I'm with Johnny's over there.
Nope.
We just brought a bunch of the stuff over here now, so we're gonna start setting it up today, at least getting the displays in place, just seeing how the format's gonna look, and then we have security systems and other stuff that we need to install, and then we'll start bringing in product. But we've got a nice Nike table right there. We got some more displays in the boxes and stuff, and we gotta get shelving up on the wall too. But this will be probably one of the first takes of us starting to set up this location. So keep watching, guys. All right, guys, so just another update. We got some stuff out of the packaging. We have our table display in the middle right here. Thing's pretty cool. It's gonna light up with an LED in the middle and there'll be sneakers in it. We have another Jordan display right there. We have a nice big LED for the middle right there that's gonna look sick. We just have shelving now that we need to put up. A couple more other things. We already got a custom street map. John made this the other day. So slowly but surely we're coming together. We have about 3.5 weeks until our planned grand opening, which is the first weekend of June. So we're gonna do our best to try and make it happen by then. All right, guys, keep watching. My first day back in the store for a couple days now. I just was real busy this weekend with the grand opening of my new gym, so I haven't been able to be here as much as I'd like to be. Store does look crazy full still though. Definitely not lacking any shoes at this location. Got a close up on the glass case here. We got a 10.5 rookie of the year right there. An 11 men's in the AMAR 3s. That's a 9.5 in the TIFFs. 10 Cactus Jack 4. That's a 10 olive. We have an 8 and a 7.5 British Khaki 6. That's a 9.5 shadow. A 10.5 gold toe. That's actually Blue Moons, Clay Greens, and Track Red ones. I believe they're all size 11. A 10.5 and an 11 in the original core purples. That's a 10 and an 8 in orange lobsters. I got a 9, 10.5, and an 11 in the Desert Moss Union 4s. We have a Supreme Camo 5, size 9.5. That's a bread toe, size 11. 11.5 men's in the Travis Scott's. There's a 13 and then a 9.5 in Motorsports. It's an old pair of ones called the Gucci Greens. They're size 10. That's a Street Hawker. Those are grade school pairs of Obsidians, 5 and 5.5. And that's a Lot Dunk, size 10. All that stuff is brand new. That's what we got in the heat case, I guess you could call it, at the moment.
I don't know, bro.
Yo, your boy plays fast pitch now all of a sudden? With Spanish? With all the Spanish people? You're a big buff guy. I used to play for Chaos with us.
Josh?
Yeah.
Lucky Greens are in a rep box too. I got them from U7 and I don't think that's what those came in, but I don't remember what the actual box looks like. Those, if you don't have a decent price, I can keep those because those are kind of beat. Those are the shoes I've had the longest, so. Yes, Cam works for a living. Those are DS. I dropped them in and never even tried them on. I didn't even. Those were the ones I was telling you about. I don't think they're DS. I think they were probably worn once, but they were labeled DS, and that's why I don't think they are. I just never personally wore them.
Yeah, they're worn.
Yeah,
I figured. You see,
yeah, you can see the toe prints. Yeah, that's gross.
There's a foot in there.
Yeah, I had a feeling those weren't. Those were a shoe I was too nervous to wear. I had a feeling I was going to do.
They were already worn anyway, though. So,
yeah, so it doesn't even. I had a beater pair of them that were like destroyed that I was wearing at one point because I was like, oh, I'm not going to wear these.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have two pairs of the same shoe.
Oh. I've done that many times now. Those are lightly worn. I'm nervous to wear those too.
There.
I literally never wore my shoes during the week. It was a weekend thing, and that was every shoe got put through a rotation of once a weekend, and it just, I don't know, sitting on my. Those, like I said, I don't know if those are rep box. I don't, those are from U7. I don't remember what the box on the Lucky Greens looked like, but that tag's from Lucky Greens, so I don't know if they just slapped it on.
This is from Rent them out, which
is it?
Yeah, it's an outlet box.
Okay, well,
yeah.
Then that's not the original.
Because
yeah. Haley sent me those and I was like, oh, I wanted those, so I knew those weren't, that wasn't the original box.
No, they're B grade.
Yeah, that makes sense then. This is what I mean. I was sitting on shoes in a closet that they never got worn.
Let me see. Because they are B-grade.
Fair enough. That's fair. I'd probably try to sell them back to Thing for whatever they offer.
I had told you a grand for everything.
Yeah, that's what. Before we realized that the Zubas weren't DS.
I'm not taking this. I can probably give you 8 for the rest.
What without the statics, what would you do?
I think I'm giving you probably like about 170 in value on those, so.
That's more than I was even gonna think, yeah.
Yeah, that's probably like one of the better ones, because they are a little worn, but they're also like a more expensive
brick. Yeah, yeah.
These,
I know,
these are a brick. I'm not giving
those
you
are
a
brick, I know.
All, bro,
I liked the color, but I'm like, I'm never gonna wear them. That was the whole thing, because I know 13s don't sell anymore, so.
Yeah.
Can you do 825? If that's too much, it's too much.
I'll do 820, that's fine.
That's cool with me. Right, so I can then try to sell those to somebody and
yeah.
I'm cool with that.
.gov/CBHCS to find your local community behavioral health center. A service of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
When you're drinking a frozen beverage from McDonald's, your brain may not like
high stress, but I only like, you know.
You said you want to store credit for them?
Yeah.
How much did you want to get for them?
Well, I mean, that's probably too high. Five too high for those, or?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. Are these DS too?
Yes.
What size is this one? You definitely want to hit that with the black light. Right.
Is that blue? God damn.
Yeah.
God damn, it's all over.
No, I know, but that means they're good, actually. They have the natural glitter in. You can see it starting to come out right there, too.
I just saw a rip on that.
I know you probably, you guys know, but I put them both through the check.
Yeah, no. They're good. The shape is good, and then on the Air Jordan, you want to make sure the R and the D are touching slightly. Yep. It's embossed in. I can see that they're glittering right there. The laces look good, the shape's good. There's no...
You can usually tell off a rip.
Yeah, no Chinese symbols on it. No smell. The YDM sticker's good. Yeah. Alright, and what are you thinking on those there for trading credit?
What's your best on the lost and founds?
Pull them up. See what you think.
Maybe, I'm thinking about maybe, I think... Well, how much are those going for right now? Lost and found is like probably like five.
Yeah, probably
less than that. With the restock, they're definitely going for less than that. But
yeah, less $450 right now.
What, ask is $450.
Sale, yeah. Sales, okay. $420.
Maybe like eight for both.
Go to the Mochas.
Yep.
Those are size 11.
Yeah.
Yeah, for trading, that's fine. We'll do eight.
Eight?
Yeah, that's fair. That's probably what I would have honestly told you. So, yeah, if you want to look around, that's okay. Fine. Unless you,
guys,
you know.
You guys have the.
No, that's fine. We'll do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll fine. That's fine. See you, bro.
Do you guys happen to have any pandas in a size 11.5?
So we're going to be trading these 2-for-1 for a dead stock pair of mochas and a dead stock pair of the lost and founds. It's an 11 mocha, 11.5 lost and found. My last pair of olives at the moment.
I went to the store yesterday and they more of a cold store like this.
Oh, sorry.
I mean, the shoe store. They don't have
here you go, Dylan. This was the guy who brought
it. No, he's finally here.
Yeah. He messaged me to this. He told me.
I told him he's going to be here when he comes in.
wanted to sell you my green vintage dump, but you have the same exact size.
Same size, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I've had that for a long time, too.
Shout out to the sneaker store.